Today, I have three compositing tips to share with you. The first one will help maintaining the integrity of fine hair strands in green screen footage. The second offers a straightforward method for achieving consistent color matching across different shots. And the third one, well, it's a secret for now, so you'll have to stay tuned until the end to discover what it is. All right, let's go. I'll start with this composition. Let's key out this girl trying to maintain as much of the hair detail as possible. I'll stop the playback and I'll also show you that there is a yellow particles background just behind her. All right, let's go over here, bring back the visibility of the layer, and then go under Effect, and from the keying category, I'll apply the key light effect. I'll click on the eyedropper and sample a green color, which gives us a really good starting point. But let's check how this actually looks by visiting first the status, which is a utility mode that will show you black should be totally transparent, white is opaque, and you should leave some gray for the in-between. So I'll open up the screen mat, I'll click near the clip black options, and I'll start to drag it, in my case, to around maybe 10, and then I'll do the opposite move for the white to clean all the specs. Next, I'll visit the screen mat to check how this looks, and if I'm happy, I can switch to final result. Now, I'm worried a bit about the edges over here, so I can shrink the edges just a touch, and I think this looks quite impressive. I'll press spacebar to play it, so every time that you are keying something, you need to play it from the beginning to the end. And I'm also going to zoom in by pressing the period key. Then let's focus over here. So we can see that we are missing a lot of details. If I'll switch off the FX icon, we can see the original plate, which has tons of fine detail hair that we are not able to maintain. One way to work is to select the layer and then just duplicate another version, which is going to thicken the underlying result because now we have two of them and will give us something better. But yet it's not perfect. So what I'll do is offer you my all-time trick, which is going to the screen mat and then changing the screen shrink grow to a positive value. So I'll click and drag to the right until I'm able to capture most of the hair strands that I'm seeing. Let's just go with a value of 100. Then I'll take the same value that I'm seeing here and I'll plug it to the screen softness. And this is going to create a nice feathering for the expansion. Then I'll select the layer in the timeline. And right now I'm actually working on the front layer, so I need to change the order. This should be the layer underneath. And then I'll select the hard light blending mode. You can also try soft light, and this depends on the quality of the footage that you're working with. So let's go with hard light. And as you can see, it kept all the fine details. Now for the replace method, I'm also going to switch it from soft color to hard color. And again, your mileage may vary depending on the clip that you are using. But let me show you the before and after. So this is what we got straight out of KeyLight without any treatment. And this is the amount of detail that we've managed to add using this simple trick. All right, I'll zoom out and I'll select the clip in the timeline, press T to show its opacity, and reduce it to say 80%. You don't want to make it over the top. Now, I do want to show you this is not a one-trick pony. So I have two other examples. Here we have this lovely girl. First, I'll switch off the second video. This is the hair treatment. And I'll show you the result that we are getting just using a single instance of KeyLight. And then if I'll switch on the second layer, you can obviously tell this is the amount of detail that we are adding to the hair. I want to zoom in just a touch and show you the before and after again. This is really impressive. And the composition is going to look more realistic. Another example over here. Again, this is the before, the regular result without any special treatment. And this is with the extra layer of detail. So again, depending on your clip, you may or may not see a big difference, but I think it's worth trying to see if you can improve the hair detail. Oh, by the way, if this is useful information, please like this video and consider subscribing to the channel. Your support is highly appreciated. And as all good things in life, it is totally free. So now let's switch back to the Happy Memories comp, the one that we started with, and try to match the colors between the foreground and the background. As you probably know, there are at least four different ways to achieve the same thing in After Effects. In fact, a couple of months ago, I've shared a cool tip for matching colors. You are more than welcome to check it out. There's a link below to the tips and trick playlist if you want to see other stuff. However, here is another method to do it, and this time using a copy of the background layer with two effects and a unique blending mode. So to do it, I'll select the yellow particles and I'll press Command D to duplicate it, and then I'll drag it above all the other clips. To this layer, I'm going to apply from the Blur and Sharpen category the Fast Box Blur, and I'll blur the heck out of it. Let's go with 40. Then I'll go back to the Effect menu, and from the Channel category, I'll add the Set Matte effect. I'll take the matte layer from the hair treatment version that we've created, so in my case, layer number 3, and I'll make sure to include effects and masks. So if I'll show it to you on its own by soloing the layer, this is how it looks. However, what I can do right now, let me just unsolo it, is change its blending mode to the color blending mode, which is just going to leave us with the color of the blurred version based on the alpha channel that we've created. I'll press T because this is way over the top, and I'll reduce it to, let's go with 30. So again, this is the before and after. It looks much more in line with the background right now. And again, just to show you, I have the same setup over here. So here is the background layer, the yellow particles, with the same two effects, and this is the before without color matching and with. Let's visit this composition, and there is a reason why I'm showing it to you twice, or actually three times. Because let's say that now your client comes to you and wants to change the shot. And this is the last tip that I have for you, which many pro users don't know, which is the fact that you can replace a clip in the project level. Of course, we all know that we can hold down Option or Alt on Windows, select a clip in the project, and then replace it with something else in the timeline, keeping all the things that we did for the previous one. But let's say that I want to do it on a project level, meaning replace all instances of this clip, no matter where it was used in the project. And to do it, I'll return back to the project panel. I'll open up the source files, and I'll select this Galaxy Particles background. And I want to replace it, of course, across the entire project. I'll hold down Option or Alt again, but this time I'll drag the galaxy particles on top of the yellow particles in the project panel. And notice that it is being replaced across the entire comps here, keeping all of the setup that we've created for all three comps intact, which is going to save you a lot of time. Let's do it again, just for fun. This time, we're going to take another background, this swirling powdered paint. Hold down Option or Alt and do the replacement number here in the project panel. So right now, we need to replace it with the galaxy particles. And this is the result that we are getting. And of course, everything is going to match accordingly. So this is it. I hope it will be useful for you in your own work. Thank you so much for sticking until the end, and I will see you again in the next one.